From the face of the fridge so that, you know, there's room on top of the fridge to set stuff. No. Not if you want a built-in look. That cabinet needs to be full depth. It needs to come out and flush with the other cabinets. And so now, on all three sides of the refrigerator, we've got flush cabinetry all the way around, okay? Now, what's the typical opening? How do you figure that out? Well, you purchase your fridge, or you at least decide which fridge you're going to get. You get the pull sheet for it. It's going to tell you what you want. But as a general rule, it's going to be this. It's going to be the width of the box of the fridge. That's the box part, not the doors, but the box width, plus a half an inch so that you can slide it in and out easily. Once it's slid in there, there's going to be just a little bit of a quarter inch gap on each side of the fridge. It's going to look very, very built in. And as far as that cabinet up on top, above it, 1 inch off the top of the fridge box. And that's usually most refrigerators spec that because there is heat that gets generated on the back side of the refrigerator, and that heat needs to get out somewhere. So we leave an inch from the box up to that upper cabinet. You're like, wow, that's really right down on it. Yeah, it is. That's how we make a refrigerator feel built in, okay? So when it's set properly, only the door edges are exposed. And if you take a look at the refrigerator that you're thinking about or your own fridge, you realize, yeah, the doors go, they have a finished edge on them. They either wrap around smoothly or there's a square edge, but they're finished. And then there's the gasket where the door meets the refrigerator box. And then the box itself, it's just painted, usually painted black. Sometimes it's painted white. Sometimes it's gray, but it's just painted. That part is not meant to be seen, not meant to be sticking out into the kitchen. So now the big issue. The big issue is that there are, as I said, two different kinds of freestanding fridges. Standard depth fridges, which are at least 30 plus inches deep, okay? Or cabinet depth fridges, which are designed to flush into that 24 inch cabinet scenario. Let's say you're one of the hundreds of my clients who look at me and say, I really would prefer not to have a cabinet depth fridge because look at these kids. Look at the size of this family. There are a lot of mouths to feed here because they've noticed something. And here's the hard truth. A standard depth fridge, or let's go the opposite way. A counter depth fridge, okay, is on average about 7 to 8 cubic feet smaller than a standard depth fridge as far as its capacity, and on average about $1,000 more. So yes, you get less refrigerator for more money. There you go. Nonetheless, counter depth fridges are very popular these days. In fact, they are probably the more popular of the choice. But what if you need more? Or what if you've got a counter depth fridge right now? I mean, a standard depth fridge right now, and you want to figure out a way to integrate it into the kitchen and get that flushed look. Well, there's a trick that sometimes, not always, but sometimes we can pull off. What we would do, if at all possible, is I'm planning out the kitchen, and I'm taking a look at the walls, and I'm trying to figure out where we might be able to set the fridge on what wall. And if we can, we will actually take out the studs right behind the fridge on that wall and turn them flat and set them to the back side of that wall. In other words, we flat stud the wall, we're going to create a little niche in the wall right behind the fridge so that a standard depth fridge has got about 3 more inches to slide back further into the wall and therefore flush itself. Now, it doesn't always work with all walls and all fridges. If it so happens that your fridge is pushed up against a garage wall, it's a given then. You can just mess something up in the garage and have a little bump out, because who cares if it makes the kitchen door, that we can make as big of an alcove as we need to make that niche trick work. And then you get a standard depth fridge, spend less money, get more storage, and it looks built in just like a counter depth fridge. But it doesn't always work, because the fridge doesn't always go on a convenient wall. But that's how we do it. Anyway, so much more to tell you about appliances. That's where we're going next. I'm so glad you joined me this morning. There's a lot more to come. You are home with Dean Sharp, the House Whisperer, and KFI.
Conway, evening. KFI.
KOST, HD2.
Los Angeles, Orange County.
Live from everywhere on the air radio.
A different looking road parade. I'm Jane and Michael Ross from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. The 133rd Tournament of Roses Parade is set to begin in just about an hour. Thousands of people camped out overnight along the 5.5-mile parade route to get a glimpse of the show of creations, marching bands, and equestrian teams in the New Year's Day tradition that was canceled last year due to COVID-19. This year, despite a surge of infections, Pasadena City officials say they have taken safety precautions. Masks, proof of COVID vaccinations, or negative COVID tests are required in the grandstands and other ticketed areas. But no mask mandate for the thousands of spectators lining the parade route. This year's theme, Dream, Believe, Achieve. Health officials in Orange County say the number of people in the hospital with COVID-19 has almost doubled since last week. Deputy Health Officer Dr. Regina Chincio Kwan says hospitals are also dealing with staffing shortages.
For those who are seeking medical continuity for other things other than COVID, unfortunately, the wait times may be longer because we expect that the hospital workers themselves may get sick.
The doctor says rapid COVID tests are getting scarce, but the county has plenty of free at-home test kits available. At least 9 of Orange County's 25 hospitals have set up search tests to handle a steady increase of COVID patients, a lot of those in effect today when it comes to five medical bills illegal.
People with medical emergencies often receive bills from doctors they didn't choose, who didn't accept their insurance. Those bills cost consumers billions each year. But the New York Times reports the new consumer protection law eliminates that risk of extra bills from out-of-network doctors or hospitals. It covers nearly all emergency medical services and most routine care. You still pay for things like a deductible or copayment, but after that normal payment, you shouldn't expect any more bills. Mark Ron, KFI News.
A man has been arrested for allegedly starting a commercial building fire in Jefferson Park. The fire damaged at least one unit of the building on West Adams Boulevard. The fire started just before 5 o'clock this morning. At least 500 homes outside of Denver have been destroyed by fire. Officials say hundreds more could be damaged. Boulder County Sheriff Joe Pelley says the wind-driven fire started on Thursday.
The fire runs in shaders based on topography and winds. And you'll see where the fire infuels. Like in gulches where there's shrubs and taller grasses, where it entered neighborhoods and took out like an entire block.
Former Denver Broncos and Atlanta Falcons coach Dan Reeves has died. Reeves died this morning. He had dementia. Reeves won a Super Bowl as a player with the Dallas Cowboys, but was best known for a long coaching career highlighted by 4 more appearances in the title game with Denver and Atlanta. He teamed with John Elway to take the Broncos to the Super Bowls in 12 seasons. Reeves also got the Falcons to their first Super Bowl during the 1998 season, but he never won a championship as a coach. He also coached with the New York Giants. Reeves was 77. Hundreds of complaints about silent riders whizzing by walkers on narrow beach trails in San Clemente could put the brakes on e-bikes.
The city drafted an ordinance that will be considered for adoption in February.
Our current consideration is banning e-bikes on all city trails.
San Clemente Mayor Gene James says it's dangerous for walkers and the bikers.
Enforcement will require resources. That is something that is very much up in the air for me on how we're going to do this.
He says there should also be more rules for e-bikes on streets, but the city may not have the power for such ordinances, and the state vehicle code hasn't kept up with technology. In Orange County, Corbin Carson, KFI News.
And this morning, some beaches are closed along the coast of Southern California because of a raw sewage spill. Long Beach City officials say 2 to 4 million gallons of raw sewage leaked into the Dominguez Channel on Thursday. The leak happened in Carson after a main sewer line failed. Now we're taking you out to a crash on the 110 in South L.A.
It's on the Harbor Freeway southbound, Jane, right by the Manchester off-ramp. For a brief period of time, that one had the inside lane taken away. Everything just got swept off over to the center divider southbound on the 110. And both sides of the Harbor Freeway between downtown and the South Bay, they're very light right now. Very good speeds on both sides of the Harbor Freeway. Here's one on the Glendale Freeway, southbound 2, trying to make that hookup onto the 5 northbound Atwater Village. Disabled rig and the right lane blocked there. Only a very brief backup. San Fernando Valley, we got you covered. West 118, Tampa Avenue off-ramp. That'll be in Porter Ranch. That 5 car wreck quickly off to the right shoulder. As is this portion on the 10 westbound Cedar Avenue. For time, the right lane had been taken away, but everything off to the right side. KFI in the sky helps get you there faster. I'm Bill Thomas.
A lower mortgage rate can make a noticeable difference on your budget. It's true. You could be saving hundreds of dollars a month simply by refinancing to one of these incredibly low rates. Think of how much that can help. Then pick up the phone and call American Financing. And do it now before rates get any higher. I mean it. Rates are expected to rise later this year. You really should not miss out on what's available now. After all, it only takes a 10-minute call to get started. You'll get a free no-obligation mortgage review, which will tell you if you can save up to $1,000 a month without resetting your term. You can choose any term 10 years and over. So don't put this off any longer. Call American Financing right now at 800-777-8109. That's 800-777-8109. Or visit AmericanFinancing.net. American Financing, NMLS 182334, NMLS ConsumerAccess.org.
Southland weather from KFI, mostly sunny and cool for the start of the new year. Rain temperatures in the valleys and inland empires in the mid-50s. Later in the afternoon, a slight warm-up with highs in the upper 50s. A chilly morning in metro LA and Orange County. Right now, highs in the low 40s, but later this afternoon, a bit warmer with highs just below 60 degrees. Mid-40s at the beaches this morning. Later today, mostly sunny with highs in the upper 50s. Right now, it's 46 degrees in Irvine, 48 degrees in San Clemente, 47 degrees in Long Beach, and 44 degrees in West Hill. We lead local life from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Jane Yamamoto.
For a custom home builder, custom home designer, here with you live, like I am every weekend, Saturdays from 6 to 8, Sundays 9 to 11. Welcome, welcome to the second hour of our fine program. What's it all about? I'm here to help. Here to help you build yourself a more beautiful home, a more beautiful life, and to do it more affordably and more artfully than you ever imagined. And artful is what we're really talking about today. In some very utilitarian ways, though. We're talking about getting appliances right in your kitchen, and really the emphasis being how to set appliances right into the kitchen, okay? A couple last items, just real quick, about refrigerators before I move off, because I've got several other appliances to at least give you some tips on. Obviously, the most built-in look for most kitchens would be to have an actual built-in refrigerator. And most built-in fridges come what we call panel ready, meaning that they don't have a factory front on them. They come equipped to have a panel inserted by your cabinet maker. Freestanding fridges can also come panel ready. Not all of them, but there are, and I think every major manufacturer has at least one or two models that will come panel ready. So that's another thing to think about. If you really want the fridge to look the most built-in and you want it to go away the most, then you can also consider, you don't have to wrestle with, should I have a painted fridge or should I get the brushed stainless steel? I'm not really in love with stainless steel. So you could consider panel ready and have your cabinet guy make panels for the front of the fridge so that it just blends in and integrates into your cabinets all the more, okay? Also, one other little tip, I don't know why this just came up in my brain, but it did, and that is, if you have a whole house filter or a whole house water softener system, in other words, you don't necessarily need the filter, the charcoal filter that is built into the fridge, and all fridges come with these charcoal filters now, and you don't want to be messing with them, all right? You don't have the option of taking it out, by the way, because if you take it out, your ice maker no longer functions. So you got to have the filter in place, and if you have it in there, it's going to wear out and need to be replaced. So what's the answer? The answer is every manufacturer that I'm aware of has as an accessory a blank, what they call a filter blank. You can order that from them. You tell them what your model number is and you say, I want the filter blank. And what it is, it's an empty tube, basically a canister that looks like the charcoal filter, but doesn't have a charcoal filter in it. It just lets the water run right through it. But it takes up the space, and it has the little chip in it so that your refrigerator reads it as a filter, and everything keeps functioning. There you go. Oh, you didn't know that, did you? No, you didn't. All right, let's move on. Let's move on to another problem item, the microwave. Microwaves are useful. They just are. No, even for excellent cooks, really good cooks, probably use them less than those of you who don't cook much and just pretty much warm up dinners or heat your hot pockets or whatever it is you do and pop your popcorn. But they're useful. And so they belong in a kitchen. You should know this if you're remodeling your kitchen. Your microwave, by code, needs a dedicated circuit just for it, okay? Ideally, you need to put that on every one of your appliances, a dedicated circuit. But the microwave, absolutely, without question. Here's the thing with the microwave. It's all or nothing. Hide it best you can somewhere. If you can, give it an open shelf to sit on so you can get it off the countertop. But if at all possible, get your microwave off the countertop, okay? Because it's taking up valuable real estate down there. I say open shelf though, okay? Because I absolutely don't want you to try and build the microwave into the cabinetry. In other words, don't build your cabinetry so that it just fits perfectly your microwave. And here's the problem. It's always been the problem with microwaves. There are no size standardizations for microwaves. None whatsoever. And that means that, maybe you've lived in a kitchen where, like in the 70s, somebody attempted to, when a house was built, it had a built-in microwave off the whole vent frame and it was all screwed into the cabinetry. And I suppose that looked great for the first 5 years until the microwave died. And then you went to replace it and you realized, the new microwave does not fit exactly. It's either a half inch too small or it's an inch too big, and we all know what that looks like. So when we talk about integrating a microwave into upper cabinetry, I'm just talking about creating an open shelf for it so it looks okay. You could have cookbooks sitting up against it on one side, and then the microwave. And that way, when it goes out and goes bad, and it is going to do that, then you just, you run to the appliance store or Best Buy or Costco and you get the new microwave of choice. You bring it home, you plug it in, you set it on the shelf next to it, and, we're back in business. The only exception to that rule, and that's if we're going to get really fancy now, which I love these, microwave drawer. Top loading microwave drawers. They go right underneath the countertop. And the reason why I give you my full approval to build in these microwaves is, number one, they're fantastic. Number two, standardization. All microwave drawers are 24 inches wide by 16 and a half inches deep. The point is, when that microwave breaks down, and it eventually it will, just like your dishwasher, just like your fridge, just like a standard size oven, you can go to the appliance store, you can get a new one, you can replace it, even a different brand, it'll slide into the same hole, and it'll be good again, and you don't have to worry about reconfiguring cabinetry. So, get your microwave off the countertop, don't build it into the upper, get it on an open shelf, integrate that into the look, or get yourself a microwave door. Now, board microwaves are about $1,000, so there you go. That's the high end of microwave. But they are replaceable, and you won't be rebuilding your cabinets as you go. All right, let's talk about wall oven when we return. I'm so glad you joined me this morning. You're listening to Home with Dean Sharp, the House Whisperer. Let's hear the news.
I'm Danielle Mucho, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. A deadly start to the new year at a popular Hindu shrine in Indian-controlled Kashmir. A group surge killed at least 12 people and injured 15 others. At least 500 homes outside Denver have been destroyed by a wind whipped fire. The flames swept over drought-stricken neighborhoods with gusts up to 105 miles per hour on Thursday. At least 7 people were injured, but there have been no immediate reports of any deaths. Pope Francis has ushered in the new year by praising the skills women bring to promoting peace in the world. Roman Catholic Church marks January 1st as a day dedicated to world peace. A look at the Drive on the 5 when we return.
Do you need a new water heater? Water Heaters Only, with over 53 years in business, offers low prices, quality same-day service, and 0% deferred interest financing. Visit waterheatersonly.com. That's waterheatersonly.com. Terms and conditions apply.
Taking it up to the 5 in L.A., where there is a
stalled big one. Yeah, if I talk about a huge backup, it's something you want to watch out for. North I-5, Glendale Boulevard off-ramp, this end of the rig, and right lane is shut down here. The wreck on the 110 southbound from Manchester off ramp very quickly out of the inside lanes over to the center divider. I don't see much of a backup there. Just a reminder, we have that 5.5 mile stretch of Colorado Boulevard all turned off due to the road grade. You can't use Colorado east or westbound. That's between Orange Grove and Sierra Madre. And right around 2 this afternoon, that should be reopening. The winds are howling. Watch your step up and down the 15 into and out of the Cajon Pass. KFI in the sky helps get you there faster. I'm Bill Thomas.
This report is sponsored by Staples Store. The new Staples Connect will change the way you think about Staples. Explore the world of possible with new small business services and innovative tools to work and learn from anywhere. Now open at 5665 West Wilshire, one block east of the La Brea Tar Pits. Learn more at staplesconnect.com/LA. This report is sponsored by Staples Store.
No one tries to be unsafe online, but during the holidays, when you give up info on privacy, you may give up safety tips.
Accept cookies to get holiday cookies? Oh, okay.
Norton 360 with LifeLock helps keep your digital world merry and bright with device security, a VPN for privacy, identity theft protection, and more. No one can prevent all identity theft, but everyone can opt in to cyber safety. Visit Norton.com/join and save 25% or more off your first year of Norton 360 with LifeLock.
Exergen would like you to know about an important study just released by the FDA. It confirms what the medical community has known all along. Non-contact thermometers are not accurate. The study also reports that they fail to meet FDA requirements for accuracy in labeling. With new strains of COVID on the rise, we can't afford to tolerate the rampant false temperature readings from non-contact thermometers. Accurate temperature measurements are essential. You need Exergen thermometers because they're accurate and backed by over 100 clinical studies. Be sure, be accurate with Exergen. Learn more at Exergen.com.
In 1982, Marissa Tate identifies Rodney Lincoln as her mother's killer. Then in 2015, Marissa says Rodney didn't do it. On the Real Killer podcast, Leah Rothman reveals what may be a miscarriage of justice.
It was one of the most brutal crimes in St. Louis history. A single mother murdered her two young daughters. I'm on a mission to find the real killer.
Listen to the Real Killer on the iHeartRadio app or wherever you get your podcasts. Mark Maxwell knows that your finances can be an uncomfortable conversation.
Mark, we should really talk about our money.
Yep, we really should.
Like, we never talk about our savings.
No, we never talk about that. Or our assets.
Or our debt.
Yeah, we really should talk about our debt.
We need one of those financial plans.
One of those will make a difference.
We should talk about it.
We really should.
Talk to us about financial wellness today. Feel comfortable about tomorrow. Mass Mutual. Live Mutual.
If you're tired of big cable bills, you can get Newsmax TV for free. Millions are watching Newsmax. Available now on major cable systems or for free on smart TVs like Samsung, LG, and Vizio. Find it streaming on Roku, Zumo, Pluto, Amazon Fire, TiVo, Apple TV, and more. 7 million Americans have downloaded the free Newsmax app on their smartphones. It takes just seconds. Then watch us anytime, anywhere. Forbes calls Newsmax a news powerhouse. Find out why. Start watching today.
Hi, Tiffany. I'm a helpful Southern California Honda person, and I'm calling to give you a random act of helpfulness.
Really?
Yeah, we heard you could use our help decorating for the holidays.
Well, my daughter, she's been fighting cancer for the past 2 years because of her immune system. She hasn't really been able to see the Christmas lights. Bringing the festivities to her, I think it would just lift her spirits and make her feel special.
Well, Honda would like to help. We're going to get your house all decorated for your daughter.
She's gonna love it. Oh my God.
Today, we help the family get in the holiday spirit. And we can help you too with great deals on select certified pre-owned Honda, like 0.99% APR financing and 24/7 roadside assistance. Visit SoCalHondaDealers.com to find a helpful Honda dealer near you. Well-qualified buyers on approved credit through Honda Financial Services. Roadside assistance available for the duration of the certified pre-owned limited warranty. Tiffany is a real person who was paid to be on the radio.
Radio advertising can connect your business with holiday shoppers wherever they go. Use iHeart Ad Builder to create an affordable custom radio ad right on your phone. Just click, listen, approve, then hear it on the radio. Create your customized ad today at iHeartAdBuilder.com.
With COVID-19 still looming, your holiday season might be more stressed than cheer. CalHope can help with free emotional support. Call 833-317-4673 or live chat at calhope.org today.
1-877-CARS-FOR-KIDS.
Donate your car today with 1-877-CARS-FOR-KIDS. We're a recognized 501c3 charity organization, so you'll receive a maximum tax deduction. What's more, you'll receive a vacation voucher of 3 days and 2 nights. Also on the web at carsforkids.com.
1-877-CARS-FOR-KIDS. Donate your car today.
We're accepting donations of land, homes, buildings, or any kind of real estate.
As 2021 comes to a close, get ready to celebrate the year in music.
We can't even have a good time.
On our 2022 iHeartRadio Music Awards.
Where the iHeartRadio app comes to life.
Coming back to Fox March 22nd.
Oh, man.
Live from Los Angeles.
iHeartRadio comes to Music Awards. A little bit different.
Are you guys ready? Where your favorite artists will go home winners. Our 2022 iHeartRadio Music Awards.
We did a blind taste test, and every single time I picked for one, it is my go-to vodka now because it actually has a lovely flavor base to it.
I encourage you to experiment.
I try and do it to push myself into textures or flavors that maybe I'm not familiar with and encourage you to do the same.
The Fork Report with Neil Saavedra
this afternoon at 2
on KFI AM 640.
More stimulating talk.
Dean Sharp, the House Whisperer, at your service. I'm so glad you joined me this morning. Hey, I would love to talk to you about what's going on with your home today. So coming up in just a few minutes, we're going to go back to the phone. The lines are open now. Now, if you can, give me a call. Jump into the queue. 833-2-ASK-DEAN. 833, the number 2-ASK-DEAN. All right, where am I in my list of getting appliances right in your kitchen? We've talked about fridges, we've talked about let's talk about, wall ovens. Built-in wall ovens, not the freestanding range. That's kind of an easier self-explanatory thing. If you've got a freestanding cooktop and range combo, you're going to make a space in your cabinetry for it with a hood above. The space in the cabinetry is going to be based on the width of the range that you pick, whether it's a 30 or a 36, those are the two most common sizes. and by the way, the options now when it comes to all ovens, whether it's the freestanding range, the double ovens built into full height wall cabinetry, the options these days are, they're really kind of mind-numbing at some point, just because everything is very, very flexible. If you prefer a gas oven, but an electric cooktop, you can get those. They're called dual fuel or dual energy freestanding cooktops. If you like it the other way around, you want a gas cooktop or an electric oven down below, those are available too. These are the kinds of things. And then there's the ongoing debate between gas ovens or electric ovens. Gas ovens are a little more quicker to respond because the flame is on or it's off. And there's more moisture inside a gas oven because that's coming through the actual natural gas that's feeding into the oven. There's a certain degree of moisture in there. So there's a higher humidity level just for the sake of the fuel. And so a lot of people who do roast and things like that, you know, keep things moist, they say, no, do a gas oven. And then you get the other side to say, no, electric ovens are crisper. There's less humidity. They make things crispy and lovely. And so it's an ongoing debate. The point is this. If you're going to put a double oven into a kitchen and you are not a cook and no one in the family is a cook or a baker, then just go with your basic straight-up double oven, whatever works for your house or your fuel supply. If it's gas, it's electric. Otherwise, let the cook figure out what kind of oven goes in there, because there are so many choices now. Double ovens can simply be two standard ovens. One is usually convection, one is usually non-convection. There is American and European convection now. You know the difference between American and European convection ovens? An American convection oven is has a fan, right? And then that's the nature of the convection oven. There's a fan to circulate the air around so that there are no cold spots or hot spots. A European convection has another burner or heat source behind the fan in the back wall or in the ceiling of the oven. And therefore, when it blows, it's not just recirculating warm air, but it's actually providing its own warm air. And most people would agree that European convection ovens are a little bit more intense and cook even faster than the American convection ovens. So there you go. Now you can get combination steam ovens. You can get steam ovens with a built-in vacuum sealer, because some steam ovens now produce so much steam that you can basically, if you've got a vacuum sealer, you can sous vide in a steam oven without the water bath, because the steam is so intense that it's basically the same as a water bath. And you can get microwave convection oven combinations and so on. The choices are deep and wide. Let the cook decide. But do your homework, because it's not just about, there's a double oven, that's what we get. There are a lot of choices. What I'm concerned about, as far as you building it into the kitchen, is again, the oven should, in an ideal situation, a double oven should be hooked up over with the fridge, with some pantry cabinets in between. In other words, if we can get one section of the kitchen with full-height cabinets, you get your pantry cabinets, you got your pillar appliances, the fridge and the double oven. So maybe pantry, double oven, pantry, fridge, pantry. You understand what I'm saying? A wall of goodness all sitting there together. Then, boom, you're done with the full-height cabinets there. And on the rest of the kitchen, the island and the other areas of the kitchen, we can talk about countertops and uppers and free open space and prep space and workspace. By combining them, it not only combines all of the pillar stuff, all the wall-based stuff in one section, which looks great, but it also frees up the rest of the counter space, so that you've got a lot of freedom to work on the practical things of food prep and all of that as you go. My only concern about the double oven is the height of the oven. Manufacturers have limits where they say, don't set it lower than this or higher than that. That's fine, stay within that. But there's a range of freedom there. And who makes that decision? The cook. The cook makes the decision. so that when those ovens open, based on the cook height and that upper oven open, that it's at a functional height for him or her to be able to reach in, pull things in and out of the upper oven. So again, you let the cook decide how high up on the wall that oven gets mounted. Okay, when we come back, I've got to talk to you about dishwashers and cooktops really quickly, and then we're also going to try and fit in another call. You're listening to Home with Dean Sharp, the House Whisperer. Let's hear the news.
I'm Jamie. I'm on Marco live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. Beloved actress and animal activist Betty Weiss is being remembered at her star in Hollywood.
People have gathered at White Stars. Many share their favorite memories of the actress. This woman says she and her mother were big fans of Golden Girls. She says it's hard to imagine Hollywood without her.
Everyone knew who she was a household name, and I think it's going to be hard to find someone to replace her.
Others who have come to her star say they were impressed with White's ability to entertain younger generations as well as older ones. Some people have left flowers on her star. Others have left photos. In Hollywood, Blake Trolley, KFI News.
A man and woman in Lancaster, both in their 20s, were shot and killed. Their bodies were found in the 1100 block of West J Avenue around 1:30 yesterday afternoon. No motive or suspect information has been released. The state funeral in Cape Town today for Archbishop Desmond Tutu.
Archbishop Desmond Tutu was without question a crusader in the struggle for freedom, for justice, for equality, and for peace.
Tutu died last Sunday. He was 90. A new report shows California police have been making fewer traffic stops, but there are racial disparities. An annual report by California's Racial and Identity Profiling Advisory Board shows traffic and pedestrian stops by state law enforcement agencies dropped 26.5% in 2020 compared to the year before. The report also found black or transgender people are being stopped and searched by law enforcement at a rate more than twice that of white or cisgender drivers. That's consistent with findings from prior years. Black people are more likely than any other racial or ethnic group to be searched, detained, handcuffed, or ordered to exit their vehicles. The report gathers data on nearly 3 million stops by 18 law enforcement agencies. Layla Muhammad, KFI News.
A massive spill of untreated sewage in the Venice Channel has closed all beaches from the Port of Long Beach north to Rancho Palos Verdes. Health officials say at least 2 to 4 million gallons of untreated sewage were released into the channel. The affected beaches will remain closed until water samples are confirmed to have bacterial levels within state standards. Residents are advised to stay out of the water department. And now headed out to the crash in Rochester, London.
210 northbound, Archibald off-ramp, very quickly out of lanes. I see everything over to the center divider, and I don't see much of a backup there either for the 210 westbound. Another wrecking of an empire at the Cedar Avenue off-ramp westbound on the 10. That's been removed from lanes as well. Watch your step up and down the 15. The winds are howling too at the home pass. Rid of debris blocking the right lane on the 110 southbound, a little below the 91. That'll be into Gardena. And we have that disabled big rig with the slow lane taken away at the Glendale Boulevard off-ramp northbound on 5 near Atwater Village. KFI in the sky helps get you there faster. I'm Bill Thomas.
Hey, have you received one of those letters about your water bill that says high usage, all in red caps? It bugs you. You probably don't know what to do about it other than tell your daughter to stop washing a new car 3 times a week or tell your son to cool it with the 45-minute shower. It gets more frustrating when, despite your best efforts, another high usage notice comes next month. Maybe you've got a leak. That's when you need to call the Water Boy, Southern California's high-tech leak detection experts. The Water Boy finds leaks, and they do it quickly and non-destructively, which means they're not going to tear anything up. State-of-the-art equipment allows them to visually and acoustically inspect your pipes, find everything from the failing toilet to a burst pipe in your slab that you don't even know was there. If you even suspect that you might have a leak, don't wait for it to get worse. Reach out to the leak experts trusted by property managers, realtors, and homeowners alike. Call the Water Boy Leak Detection today. 818-518-5050. 818-518-5050. Or visit thewaterboy.com.
This is what you're doing. When I was in junior high school, I was totally so badly. I tried.
Hello, I'm John Quinn, owner of Rooter Hero Plumbing. I was called a bonus after my grandfather, but as a kid, I was teased for having that name, so I changed it to John. John is the English version of Obama, and it means comes the honor to my grandfather. My family and heritage are important to me. The things that are lost in Rooter Hero Plumbing are important. Staying true to Rooter Hero Plumbing means true to you and delivering world-class service. That's why my cell phone number is on the back of every Rooter Hero Plumbing business card. Call us at 866-377. And we'll cable you around
for $77. Toy store right now. Cruising in the bridge out of my control.
The word is out. People are abandoning their overpriced wireless carriers and swapping to the same 5G coverage, but at a fraction of the price. In fact, the average family spends over $800 a year on switching from Verizon, AT&T, or T-Mobile. And switching is so easy. You can keep your phone, keep your number, or get your podcast on the latest iPhones and Androids. Right now, you can get unlimited talk, text, and 6 gigs of data for just 30